When I graduated college, I was living in my parents' garage, and I'd never told my dad I did any kind of drugs, and my dad never told me that he did any drugs. He went to college in Miami in 1969. Woodstock marched naked through his fucking apartment. Never touched drugs, right? So this one day we had plans to go play golf, this little shitty three-par golf course. I decided I was gonna share. My dad comes in the garage and I go, "Pop, I've got pop brownies, if you're interested." My dad gets real nervous and sweaty all of a sudden and he goes, "Let's do that shit, baby." I don't know why he was calling me baby. It was like drug terminology already shooting back from the 60s. But we eat these brownies and we drive his beat up old Cadillac to the golf course. Three holes into the round of golf, I get fucked up. I'm not even hitting a ball anymore. I was like talking to the squirrels. I humped a tree at one point. It was just very splintery. I don't recommend that at all. And my dad starts talking trash. He goes, "I guess you can't handle your shit, baby." And I was like, first of all, maybe it hasn't hit you yet, Pops. Secondly, stop calling me baby. Freaking me out, all right? It has now become dark. Night has fallen upon us. My dad starts to act kind of weird, kind of messed up. And we're driving home. I said, "Dad, can we stop at Starbucks for 2 minutes? He goes, "Yeah, baby, that's cool." I was like, "Pop, why don't you just stay in the car? I'll be right out, okay? 2 minutes." He goes, "Cool, baby, cool, cool." I go in Starbucks. I come out 2 minutes later. My dad is gone and the car is gone. So I begin the 3 mile foot journey home. 6 blocks into my walk, my dad pulls up along real slow in the car, gets out, and here were his exact words. He goes, "Ben, I'm freaking out, man." Then he got weirder. He was like, "I felt like I was floating above the earth and it was like a grid. I didn't know how to find you or your mom or your brother." And I said, "Dad, I have a question. Can I drive home?" So we switch seats. I drive home. We pull into the driveway. All of a sudden, my dad gets real nervous and sweaty again. And he goes, "Ben, you can't tell your mother about this. I'll get a fucking divorce. You can't tell your mother about this." I said, "No problem, because I know how to lie like a normal human being." So I walk in. I go, "Hi, Mom. Good night." Here is exactly how my dad walks in the house. "What?" I said, "Mom, Dad ate pot brownies. I don't want to think you accidentally killed a guy on the way home. Stuffed his body in the trunk or some shit." 3 o'clock in the morning, my dad's sleeping on the living room couch. I woke him up and I said, "Dad, I guess you can't handle your shit, baby." Felt good. Felt very good. But then, cut to about 10, 12 years later, just 6 months ago, I was at my parents' house with my brother and sister-in-law and little almost two-year-old nephew, having a nice, lovely family time. I decided I'm gonna eat 2.5 pot cookies. Seemed like the right thing to do when hanging out with your family. I ate 2.5 pot cookies. We're sitting there in the living room, having a nice family conversation, and I begin to die. I'm 100% dying right here. I know I'm dying, but they're having such a fun time. I don't want to interrupt the family time with my death. I want to die quietly in the corner, let them enjoy their time. So I'm 100% dying here in the corner. And eventually my mom notices this and says, "Are you okay?" And I said, "Well, now that you bring it up, Mom, I am not okay. Could you by chance bring me a drink?" She's like, "Anything you want." I said, "By chance, could you bring me a water and a tea and a Sprite and a ginger ale?" She brought me all four of those beverages, which I drank very quickly and then ran to the back of the house where I began to projectile vomit into a bucket because I'm a gangster, okay? I decided the night was done for me, it's time for bed. I crawl literally to the spare bedroom and the bed in there is way too high, much like myself. It is a very high bed. I am very high. I can't get up there. I'm gonna sleep on the floor right here. 36-year-old man, I say to my mother, "Mom, by chance, would you mind sleeping on the floor with me while holding my hand? So in case I begin slipping towards death again, you will feel my death slide and save my life." And my mom did it. She slept on the floor holding my hand. Yeah, it's an amazing mother. And no kidding, my dad came and checked on us in the middle of the night, opens the door. Once he knew we were okay, my dad, without missing a beat, says, "I guess you can't handle your shit, baby." Funniest thing I ever heard. He waited 10 years for that joke. While I was dying, I was like, "Great joke, Pop. Very nice joke."